What's up, everybody? Gen X Dividend Investor here. In this video, I'm going to reveal the top 10 dividend stocks for May that thousands of dividend investors on my Discord chat server had the opportunity to vote for that they're buying or plan to buy. And I must say, I was surprised at some of the results. So if you appreciate free content like this, then please consider hitting the thumbs up button, subscribing if you haven't yet, and click that bell notification. Now, normally you want to look at financial metric trends and other info when you're analyzing stocks to invest in, and it's important to realize that people vote for stocks in polls like this for a variety of reasons, including maybe just because they own it. And since they're all on my dividend Discord, there may be some bias towards stocks I own. Anyways, this is just a video for fun, and in it I'll be showing you some metrics that are mostly from my spreadsheet product, which is a tool that is a perk that my Patreon aristocrats and kings get access to as part of their monthly membership. So let's get it on. That's what she said. The 10th most popular stock in the poll with 18% of voters is Visa, ticker V, which is one of the most dominant credit card companies in the world. I'm not long on them, but I like them. Visa has a consensus analyst rating of a buy, and okay, 12 consecutive years of dividend increases, a nice low payout ratio of 23%, a low 0.55% yield, a powerful 22% 3-year dividend CAGR, and a high 54 PE. Visa is at about $234 a share, just below the 52-week high of $236 and well above their 52-week low of about $172. Visa seems pretty expensive to me at these levels, but the markets are hot these days. Okay, the 9th most popular stock in the poll with 21% of voters is a healthcare stock I own, and that's Pfizer. Pfizer has a consensus analyst rating of a hold, and okay 11 consecutive years of dividend increases, a seeking alpha payout ratio of 47%, a nice 4.02% yield, a decent 3-year dividend CAGR of 5.9%, and a high PE of almost 31. Pfizer has been instrumental in creating vaccines which are being used worldwide, so it's great to hear as a shareholder, and it should be a nice revenue bump for them as well. Pfizer is at about $38 a share, below their 52-week high of $43, and above their 52-week low of about $30. Full disclosure, I have some close friends that have worked at Pfizer for a long time. Okay, let's move on. The 8th most popular stock in the poll with 22% of voters is Altria, ticker MO, a stock I'm long in. Altria has a consensus analyst rating of a buy, an incredible 51 consecutive years of dividend increases, making them part of the elite dividend kings list. Have a seeking alpha payout ratio of 75%, a yummy 7.29% yield, a strong 10.94% 3-year dividend CAGR, and a 19 PE. Altria is facing some headwinds with increasing regulatory risk as of late, thus have been pushed down a bit. Altria is at about $46 a share, below the 52-week high of 52-ish, and above the 52-week low of about 35. If you want to invest in this space, then PM is another one I like and own that is focused internationally. Okay, let's move on. The 7th most popular stock in the poll with 25% of voters is one I'm long in, and that's Kimberly-Clark, ticker KMB. KMB has a consensus analyst rating of a hold, an almost kingly 49 consecutive years of dividend increases, a 64% payout ratio, a decent 3.52% yield, a weak 3.45% 3-year dividend CAGR, and almost a 20 PE. KMB is at about $132 a share, which is below its 52-week high of about $160 and above their 52-week low of $128. Kimberly-Clark has been trending kind of sideways, though I think the recent dip is prompting some people to get in. Okay, let's continue. The 6th most popular stock in the poll with 28% of voters is my favorite consumer staples food and beverage company that I'm long in, and that's Pepsi, ticker PEP. Pepsi is a consensus analyst rating of a hold, are another one with almost a kingly 49 consecutive years of dividend increases, have a 75% payout ratio, have a low 2.88% yield, a decent 8.29% 3-year dividend CAGR, and about a 27 PE. Pepsi is at about $144 a share, which is below its 52-week high of about $149 and above their 52-week low of about $126. Pepsi has been gradually trending up over the last year, and I'm digging it. Okay, let's continue. The 5th most popular stock in the poll with 33% of voters is my favorite communication services stock I'm long in, and that's AT&T, ticker T. T has a consensus analyst rating of a hold, an awesome 37 consecutive years of dividend increases, a seeking alpha payout ratio of 65%, a high 6.72% yield, and a low 2% 3-year dividend CAGR. T is at about $31 a share, which is just below its 52-week high of about $33 and above their 50-week low of about $26. Could we finally be witnessing a longer-term bullish trend for AT&T? Let's hope HBO Max continues to perform well, and that AT&T's management can tame their debt. Okay, let's continue. The fourth most popular stock in the poll with 33% of voters is my favorite industrials company I'm long in, and that's 3M, ticker MMM. 3M has a consensus analyst rating of a hold, a kingly 63 consecutive years of dividend increases, a 63% payout ratio, a relatively low 3.02% yield, a decent 7.75% 3-year dividend CAGR, and a 20 PE. 3M is at about $199 a share, which is just below its 52-week high of about $203 and well above their 52-week low of about $131. Take a look at that nice one-year trend. Awesome. Okay, moving on. The third most popular stock in the poll with 37% of voters is one of my favorite tech stocks, and that's Microsoft, ticker MSFT. Microsoft has a consensus analyst rating of a buy, a nice 19 consecutive years of dividend increases, a nice low 31% payout ratio, a very low 0.88% yield, a nice 9.16% 3-year dividend CAGR, and a 34 PE. Microsoft is at about $251 a share, which is below its 52-week high of about $263 and well above their 52-week low of about $172. Microsoft is one of my all-time favorite stocks, and lately I've been playing Divinity 2 on the Xbox with a buddy of mine. It's super fun, and I can't wait for Baldur's Gate 3. Okay, moving on. The second most popular stock in the poll with 39% of voters is my favorite company in the world, and has been since I was in elementary school, and that's Apple, ticker AAPL. Apple has a consensus analyst rating of a buy, an okay 9 consecutive years of dividend increases, a very nice 21% payout ratio, a very low 0.61% yield, a nice 9.83% 3-year dividend CAGR, and a 30 PE. Apple is at about $134 a share, which is below its 52-week high of about $145 and almost double their 52-week low of about $71. Insane. My love for computers and the reason why I originally became a programmer was because of Apple, so they hold a special part in my heart. Okay, moving on to numero uno. The most popular stock in the poll with 42% of voters is one of my favorite healthcare stocks out there, and that's AbbVie, ticker ABBV. AbbVie has a consensus analyst rating of a buy, an almost kingly 49 consecutive years of dividend increases, a seeking alpha payout ratio of 42%, a sweet 4.65% yield, an amazing 22.6% 3-year dividend CAGR, and a 40 PE. I'm sure that most of you are aware of one of the risks with AbbVie, which is that their biggest revenue drug, Humira, has some patent protection risk that they're trying to mitigate. AbbVie is about $111 a share, which is just below its 52-week high of about $113 and way above their 52-week low of about $79. Nice. Try to find another company that has that many consecutive years of dividend increases combined with that current yield and that high of a dividend CAGR. Also, watch my recent video on dividend aristocrats to understand why AbbVie is officially considered one, even though they only sprang into existence in 2013. Now, some dividend stocks that I think are still worth considering are strong oil companies. I personally believe that ExxonMobil will raise their dividend this year, continuing their streak, unless things turn drastically around due to the pandemic or something unanticipated. I also think that there are a lot of strong aerospace companies that have pretty compelling financials that are worth evaluating. So those include Lockheed Martin, ticker LMT, Raytheon Technologies, ticker RTX, General Dynamics, ticker GD, and Honeywell International, ticker HON. Now, while this video is primarily about the top dividend stocks people are investing in, I think it is also important not to leave out growth stocks. Amazon is one of those companies that I like to DCA into, as is Google. I also think that Ethereum is a crypto that is interesting enough to evaluate, albeit at a different risk profile than growth stocks, but I think it also has a higher potential long-term return. Anyways, now I'd like to shout out a recent subscriber who just joined my team as a Patreon aristocrat. So thank you to Gnarly for signing up. Aristocrats gain access to my dividend spreadsheet product that I use in this video, and to multiple private channels on my Discord, including one where I let them watch my videos before I release them to the public, as well as a channel which lets them vote on which thumbnails I use for my videos, and of course they get more direct access to me. Finally, I highly recommend that everyone join my free dividend Discord chat server, which has thousands of dividend investors on it and is growing all the time. And since you watched this video all the way to the end, I'll tell you an awesome dad joke. But first, please hit the thumbs up button, subscribe if you haven't yet, and click that bell notification. So today I ordered a chicken and an egg from Amazon. I'll let you know the answer in my next video. Actually, the real answer is that the egg came first, but what laid the egg isn't what you'd call a chicken. Let your brain noodle on that tonight. Thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you again real soon.
I am not a financial advisor, and these videos are for entertainment, inspiration, and educational purposes only. Investing of any kind involves risk. I am only sharing my opinion with no guarantee of gains or losses on investments.